You all know the current farm models with machinery to support livestock production and nutritious food for pigs. In this video, you will see a completely new model, the organic pig farming model. Let's explore this topic with us. Organic pig model, pig farm model eating agricultural products. Currently, I am in the western part of Iowa, home to the largest concentration of pig farms in the US. A notable feature of some organic pig farms here is the outdoor raising of pigs. During pregnancy, pig mothers are released into the fields, where their cubs will coexist with the natural environment. The notable difference between organic pig farming and traditional pig farming is that organic pigs do not damage crops. They choose large areas of land to build pig farms. Pig houses are transported and placed in areas on the farm. This is one of the places for pigs to rest after dark. Inside the shelters, dry straw is prepared for them to eat and sleep. After weaning, piglets will be brought back to live in separate breeding areas. In these areas, they will be provided with additional cereals and nutritional powders so that they can soon adapt to new foods other than breast milk. The large environment has comfortable space for them to run, jump, and play in the cage. After they can adapt to their new living environment, they will be released to search for food on their own. Veterinary experts say that piglets raised on a free-range model often have better health conditions than pigs raised in barns all their lives. A pig mother usually gives birth to between 9 and 15 babies, and their breeding process involves less intervention to ensure the piglets have enough milk and are safe from threats from the natural environment. These farms are often located in wooded areas, allowing the pigs to eat a diverse diet, including insects, plants, and seeds. This improves the quality of pork and produces a product that is more prized than pork from large-scale farms, where pigs are often kept in cages for life. Strong fencing is an important part of outdoor pig farming. Once the piglets are strong enough, they will be released and free to perform their natural behaviors. These pigs will live outdoors all their lives, only being locked into cages when the weather is too cold. This is similar to how wild boars live and survive in the wild. In the US, fences around farms are essential to ensure the safety of pigs and prevent them from escaping into the woods. Wild pigs in the US have become a feral species after hundreds of years of escaping from farms. However, pigs raised outdoors have a different life. They usually live with their mothers for about 50 days. Twice as long as pigs raised in the traditional model. Pigs raised outdoors often do not eat or eat very little of the food provided to gain weight as quickly as traditional pigs. pork harvest time on organic farms usually lasts 8 to 9 months instead of 5 to 6 months on large-scale farms. On organic pig farms in Iowa and other states such as North Carolina, Minnesota, and Missouri, the main feed for the pigs is usually silage and grain. In addition, fresh vegetables and fruits are often used regularly to improve the quality of pork. This means that organic pork has a high nutritional value and is a good choice for people who want to consume clean and healthy food. They eat these vegetables every day, which are very cheap and easy to find in stores or supermarkets. Not only that, they will be able to eat a number of different agricultural foods. The farm owner here is feeding them one-week-old rice sprouts. This is a nutritious food that is very good for the digestive system of pigs. Sowing rice seeds is quite simple. The rice is soaked until it begins to germinate, then placed in trays placed in a closed watering and warming system. After about a week, the rice seeds will sprout and can now be fed directly to the pigs. Not only pigs, but any livestock species like to eat this type of food. A nutritious food that very few farms know about. Is your farm using this method of feeding pigs? You can say that organic pork is a new trend among consumers and producers of organic pork because the food is 100% natural, so this is the best sustainable method for the market. Today, under the negative impacts on the environment, mousefarm and agriculture believes that what we share here will help many farmers and all people who love agriculture in the world today. Remember to subscribe and press the bell button down here to receive our latest and most useful videos, and continue watching this video with me.
Surprisingly, the main material for making paper is wood. The most common used trees for paper production are coniferous forest trees, such as pine, tamarind, and cypress, because of their high cellulose content. Before processing, the wood must be treated and separated into small logs. Wood-based paper production must comply with environmental regulation and requirements. Paper manufacturers must ensure that their wood sources are protected and sustainable, and that they comply with regulations regarding the use of chemicals in the paper making process. In addition, paper manufacturers must also implement waste treatment and recycling measures to minimize the environmental impact from the production process. First, the wood is washed with water as it passes through a conveyor belt. They are then crushed into wood chips and cooked in a decomposition furnace. They will be cooked in a temperature of 170 degrees Celsius with water and some chemicals to remove lignins, a substance that creates the binding of wood fibers. Cellulose pulp will be separated from unnecessary waste, forming a large amount of pulp. Now it's time to shape the papers. The pulp is compressed into a large sheet of paper and pulled into rolls at a speed of about 80 to 90 km per hour. Through rollers, The previous layer of pulp is pressed into large paper sizes, then it was rolled up into scrolls. They are transported to another processing conveyor. At this point, the paper rolls are put into a machine to squeeze the water contents in the paper out and reduce the moisture of the paper surface. They are then dried using several metal cylinders at a temperature of about 100 degrees Celsius. At the next stage, these giant rolls of paper are labeled with information by staff and using a device to coat them with a special compound to improve paper quality and increase shelf life. Each roll of these papers is about 8.6 meters long. Because of the large size, these paper sizes have to be chopped into smaller sheets for easy transportation and to suit the needs of consumers. Finally, they will be packed into the packaging and shipped to the buyers. This stage is done entirely by machines to ensure high precision. The toilet paper production line will have a few points that surprise you. To make toilet paper rolls, the paper must be processed on a different conveyor belt, similar to the way to create pulp from wood in the line above. But the pulp will now be combined with recycled paper such as newspapers, office paper, recycled paper scraps. This is put into a large tube to wash with water to remove the ink and form a paste. Next, the pulp will be processed by rollers to shape, while processing the paper, these rollers will compress the surface of the paper to create a flatness, and water will be removed as much as possible so that the pressed paper has the lowest moisture. A cylinder is heated to a temperature of 100 degrees Celsius to produce steam. This way, as the paper passes through the cylinder, they will be softened. When the paper reaches the desired quality, they are rolled into large paper tubes, weighing about 2 tons of paper per roll. Once completed, these giant rolls are transported by an automatic machine to another processing area. Here they will be spread out and rolled into smaller paper tubes to form toilet paper rolls. This paper tube has a length of 50 meters after rolling the paper. They will be chopped into rolls. Now it's time to pack. These small rolls of toilet paper run on a conveyor belt to the packing area. They are packed fully automatically. According to statistics, about 420 million tons of paper are produced each year to serve human needs, in which major paper consuming countries such as the United States, China and Japan have a wood consumption volume of about 300 million.
So how do you feel about this video? And do you think that in the future a lot of machines are going to replace more humans, and how can we face that problem in the future? Please share your comments down below, as this is going to be very, very important to know pretty much from almost everyone, so that we can hear more opinions and get introduced to more solutions. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe for more videos like this.